We got 15 of Joe Curry, the 02 Chevy Camaro, alongside Steve Alvin, and that 98 Jeep Cherokee. Waving the stars and stripes from the tailgate, away they go down into one, and it's Perry. Cruising through two and down the back straight in his Camaro. Steve Alvin, though, loves that high line. He's gonna slide his Cherokee around, look to the inside, not gonna have enough time, though. Joe Perry edging out Steve here in round two. Next up, it's Sean Beckert in that brand new, clean looking Dodge Charger. Up against the facade of Josh Oliveira, down they go. That VW with the early lead, but I'm sure that Charger would make it interesting, you would think, but it's gotta be the Passat stretching its legs around four. Who would have thunk? Oliveira.
I don't know, I'm disappointed in that Charger. That sounds mean, but runs around like a pussycat.
Yeah. Next up, Brian Hartling back in his 02 Chevy Corvette alongside Brad Johnson in his 2010 Camaro SS. It's an all Chevy grid for this one. Away they go. Brian Hartling, early advantage through one and two, cruises up and down the back straight. Johnson trying to make it close through three, gains on the vet. Hartling though steps on it out of four, gets to the line first. Brian Hartling, your winner in this one.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think? The stealth? The Pontiac Firebird.
Down into one they go, and Kazunas stretches his legs early one. Multi-car length lead through 3 and 4, and Pizzuta's going to cruise on and tear down the checker.
I think that Silverado needs to go help Lumberjack with some of that load.
The 97 Firebird alongside Richie Johnson, the 99 Camaro. They wait for the signal. Wrapped his 99 Camaro off the two. Through the smoke plumes on the back straight. Corey Perry trying to close up the gap. Not gonna cut it. Richie Johnson takes the checker. David Toll is the Nissan back to place up four, going up against John Fielding in this one. Fielding with the early jump off the line. What can the little Nissan do?
The little Nissan can watch that Camaro pull away.
And so he does. John Fielding through three. Toll got to try and take one last stab at it. But he's going to have to settle for a second as Fielding slides that Camaro through one. Woo-hoo! Back up to the top. Walter Wickenbach taking on Christy Pierce. Trans Am versus Camaro. Take your pick. They wait for the signal. Off they go. Down into one. Walter Wickenbach wraps Trans Am to through one and two. Christy Pierce making it look interesting into three. Closes that gap a bit. Comes up on the high line. Not going to have enough time though. As the one pulled up at the line, but with enough of the gap.
He was playing Gingerbread Man. Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch the Gingerbread Man.
Car at 49 F2.
Do you think the Ford pickup's
So that's four and ten surprise. That's got pace. Not stoked though with the edge. Yep, two. This one on four, not gonna be enough though.
Good run from the Farias there. Locks himself in for another round.
V versus V. It's like Spy versus Spy. Volkswagen versus Vega. How many people got the Vega in this one? How many people got the Passat?
I'll take the Vega with the early lead into one. Passat, what can it do off of two? Andrew Joseph, though, cruising around in that 75 Vega. Passat dives it in deep off of four to try and make up ground, runs out of time. Andrew Joseph in the Chevy Vega, moving on. Steve Alvin back to Moore in the 98 Cherokee. Steve Alvin rolling up to the line, now in reverse. A little burnout action to come. The 11th car of Jared Smith in the 90 Corvette rolls up alongside. Down the great start from Alvin at the line. Tied together through one and two. Steve Alvin, though, tied to that high groove. Red, white, and blue waving in the wind as he comes off the floor. He's going to pull that one forward behind him. Steve Alvin cruises on for another win today.
And all the Corvette lovers are hanging their heads. I can't believe I lost to a G.
Brad Johnson on the outside, Joe Perry on the inside. The old versus the new, or really the newer versus the not as new, down into turn one and two. It's Joe Perry off of two, but here comes Johnson with a big surge down the back street. High line through three and four. It's going to be a bad one off of four.
Right in the
high line takes it. Brad Johnson rolls on in this one.
I'm glad he didn't have to go up against the Jeep.
whittling down the field now. It's a blistering start off the line. He's going to lead the 28 car. Handily down the back straight. Mike Benson popping and bagging his way down into one and across the line. Mike Benson takes down the checker.
Once again, we want to ask our fans, there is no standing. fly. Please return to your seats.
22. Side by side, John Fielding at the 22. I'm cruising on down the back straight. Through the restart zone off the 4. John Fielding. Gonna lead the 15 by several car lengths and take down the win.
I knew a Camaro was gonna win that one.
Even though he lost his last round, it is a double elimination. You gotta lose twice to be out.
John Johnson, alongside Mike Benson. Mike Benson, popping and banging his way down into one, jumps out ahead of Johnson. Trying to make up for lost time, does so into three, spokes the tires, drives the berm. Mike Benson, though, too quick and smooth. Around the paved oval, Mike Benson gets back in the winner's column. Take down a Camaro. Middle of two. Hardly pulling ahead just into three. Johnson. that time, Brian Hartling takes down the checkered. Getting down to the nitty-gritty of it now. Offside, Richie Johnson on the inside. Backfires all the way. Close. Almost contact. Mike Benson having to give racing room to Johnson. Squirrely Johnson hangs on for dear life. A handful for Johnson across the line. And Richie Johnson bends off the VR4. Takes down the checker. Tom Kazunas squaring off against Gil Bradstreet. Bradstreet into one. Bradstreet having to use the brake pedal, something he's not used to in these heats. Drag race down into three. Bradstreet handling the rear. Kazunas though at the line. Shows up the spectator drives. Move on. Brian Hartling in the middle on the outside. The ferry is on the inside of the stealth. They battle off of two. Corvette battles back on the outside. Sends it into three. Tries to make the high line work. Just don't have enough pace. Just enough at the checkers. Joe DeFarius taking down yet another checker flag. Semi-final squared off here as we have some action now through the infield.
So ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a three-car finale, two laps.
Mike Vincent takes place on the inside. Joe DeFerris on the outside. Richie Johnson. Three-car driver, Mike Vincent takes advantage of the inside pole.
Coming here, I just wasn't letting off, man.
Yeah, and especially that two-car final really worked. worked into your advantage. He had the lead after one, but you were able to get the inside advantage, and how did you make it stick on that second lap?
I don't know, I knew he slid up a little bit, and I just had to stay in it, stay under him, and just try and keep it straight. It's really hard with that bump down there. I was just hanging on.
Well, certainly a heck of a drive today, and anyone you'd like to thank for getting this thing out here today?
This guy right here, I can't tell you how many hours he's put in this car. We raced this car in memory of my best friend, who was one of his closest friends. The three of us bought this car together, we got it running together, we raced it together, fixed it together, and we lost him a couple of years ago, and from here on out, before it was just, you know, let's go out and have fun, and once he passed, it kind of turned into like, we got to win one for him, and I don't care how much money it took. I'm sure my dad does, my dad's probably pissed, but hey, we did it. Happy Father's Day, Dad!
That's right, well, certainly honoring him today, and a heck of a drive, so congratulations again. One more time, folks, your Spectator drag winner, Richie Johnson.